Welcome to the California Department of Education Integrated and Designated English Language Development Transitional Kindergarten through Grade 12 video series. Designated English Language Development, building into and from mathematics in Grade 4. In this lesson, the students are learning and practicing how to write mathematical arguments. They intentionally listen, speak, read, and write in order to build language and linguistic structures. The students will use these language resources to accurately demonstrate their understanding of math content in writing, now, as well as when they return to their math class. The focal California English Language Development Standards driving this lesson. The English Language Development Standards at the bridging level are Grade 4, Part 1, Standard 1. Exchanging information and ideas, where students contribute to class, group, and partner discussions, including sustained dialogue, by following turn-taking rules, asking relevant questions, affirming others, adding relevant information, building on responses, and providing useful feedback. Grade 4, Part 1, Standard 10A, Writing, where students write longer and more detailed literary and informational texts collaboratively and independently using appropriate text organization and growing understanding of register. And Grade 4, Part 2, Standard 1, Understanding Text Structure, where students apply understanding of how different text types are organized to express ideas, to comprehending text, and writing cohesive text. Watch how students move from early levels of proficiency toward the bridging levels of these English language development standards throughout the lesson. The supporting California Common Core State Standards for Mathematics, used in tandem with the focal English language development standards. The mathematics standard is Grade 4, Number and Operations in Base 10, Standard 5. Use place value understanding and properties of operations to perform multi-digit arithmetic, where students multiply a whole number of up to 4 digits by a 1-digit whole number and multiply 2 2-digit numbers using strategies based on place value and the properties of operations. Students illustrate and explain the calculation by using equations, rectangular arrays, and/or area models. Watch for how these California standards are addressed throughout the lesson. Watch how the teacher leads the students through a series of activities that allow them to write a mathematical argument with an increasing degree of independence using newly learned language structures and vocabulary through mathematical discourse. The students speak with their peers to collaboratively reconstruct an argument that has been cut into strips. They apply their understanding of how an argument is structured, accurately using academic vocabulary.
And I'm going to hand out to you some envelopes that have a paragraph written and cut into strips. What you're going to do is you're going to arrange these strips in order that makes sense to you and your partner, and you're going to put them on this graphic organizer. You're going to want to have your claim, your evidence, and your explanation of your evidence. Okay? Are there any questions? Awesome.
I think it's in the claim because it says that we know that Alberto made a mistake and met the W. And then that is, and like it's telling us into like our claim. Yeah.
What do you think? I think for evidence we should put, I think our evidence will be he multiplied 2 times 1 when he should multiply 2 times 10.
What else should we put? Since we have 2 more left. Okay, I think we should put the correct answer is
1,008.
You'll put here, and then for this one, it could be here or here. What are those two?
I think this is an arrow and place value. I think we should put it in explaining.
Yeah.
Explain of evidence.
Great. Now let's read it again. Maybe it makes sense. I know that Aristotle made a mistake in method X. He multiplied 2 times 1 when he should have multiplied 2 times 10. This is an error in place value. The correct answer is 1008. I think we got it right.
Watch how the teacher prepares the students to use learned language structures through mathematical discourse. The students use their learned language to explain their reconstructed argument and cite evidence.
Who can tell me what they think the evidence is in this? And now I'm seeing that you have two different explanations of the evidence going on, and that's okay. I just want to hear your thinking. So let's start with Antonio and his partner.
He multiplied 2 times 1 when he should multiply 2 times 10.
The correct answer is 1008.
Do we agree?
Yes.
No? Say, Omar, why do you not agree?
Because I think those two should go on explanation of evidence because it's saying where he made the mistake and what's the correct answer.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And why do you think the correct answer belongs up in the evidence?
Because it's only what he did wrong.
Okay. We're going to say that it's Antonio, the evidence includes the right answer. Because we're going back to our numbers, and the numbers where we're citing our source from our reading, we're going back to the numbers, and we're including the numbers into our evidence. So next week, when we go back to our posters, can you help your group with this? Because that's what they're going to do next, right? They're going to be identifying the claim, and you're going to be the experts on it, right? You're going to be able to help them.
Watch how the teacher prepares the students to apply their understanding of an argument with an increasing degree of independence using learned language structures through mathematical discourse. The students write to explain their reconstructed argument.
Now, do you think you can do it on your own?
Yes!
Okay. Try to do it by yourself. This is not partner work. But at the very end, you can check it with your partner when I say so. But your eyes should be on your own paper, trying to do it by yourself at first. But I know you guys can do it. Are we ready?
Yes.
Let's read what we wrote.
I know
Alberto made a
mistake.
He multiplied 2 times 1. The correct answer is, this is an in. So we all agree. Awesome. Nice. So when we go back to our groups, will you be able to help them?
Yes.
Okay, great.
Beyond the designated English language development lesson, building into and from content instruction. By engaging in designated English language development lessons such as this one, the students are better prepared and more confident to express their growing math content knowledge in speaking, reading, and writing during collaborative activities with peers, in small groups, as a whole class, and individually with diminishing supports.
Eduardo made a mistake in
method X. We know this because in method X, it shows that 72 times 14 in the beginning, but when they do the math, it shows a 4 instead of a 14.
Reflection and discussion. Reflect on the following questions. First, how did you observe the following focal English language development standards and supporting content standards being implemented in this grade 4 designated English language development lesson? English language development, part 1, standard 1, exchanging information and ideas. Part 1, standard 10A, writing. Part 2, standard 1, understanding text structure. And number operations in base 10, standard 5. Second, what features of designated English language development did you observe in the lesson? Now pause the video and engage in a discussion with colleagues. The California Department of Education would like to thank the administrators, teachers, and students who participated in the making of this video. This video was made possible by the California Department of Education in collaboration with WestEd and Tambor Films.